really beautiful, like, biome over here next to it. Like, swamp and
piston's not sticking. That's what she said.
Maybe wrong item on it won't stick, or wrong piston. Oh, you know what? We could put the horse race track up here in the desert. That's way, like, Arabian style. Let's do that. Let's do that. Everyone hear me on that?
Yeah, horse race track.
Up here in the desert city. That way that city has something to offer. People won't have it right away. I don't know, Fear. Where are you? Are you back at our houses area?
Obsidian. I got bedrock to stick to it before.
I don't know. Take the piston away and put another one down and start from scratch. Gotta take my own advice. Quit flying so fast there. I haven't even, like, walked around on this map yet to see what, like, things are on ground level in some of the areas. It's all flying and landing. Gotta put some chests underwater here.
Chests.
No, I don't want to be on chests right now. I'll get stuck on chests for them. So, Pro put a full set of armor at the end of the maze called Armor of the Hezen Pig, and also put a sword. Nice. Now, it's up to you guys at home to keep track of your creations, like I said. Oh, wow. I need somebody that might want to help build a fucking badass jungle temple. I just found the badass place to build it. Oh, my God. I'm going to put a beacon here just to help remember where it is. Like I said, beacons are a good place to mark adventure, but you want to turn them off down the road. Like, use beacons in creative mode this first month or so, or whenever, however long it takes us to make it, to remember where you're working and ideas of where to go. But down the road, the beacons are only going to be for the cities. And then we'll work from there. I just don't want people to be like, ooh, light, I must go there. Ooh, light, I'm going to go there. I want them to actually, like, you know, we'll randomly drop, like, maps and treasure maps and stuff on them. And, like, they'll be floating, and then all of a sudden... Like, you see how this cave's way down deep?
I can't wait to be able to write on books, so we can...
Yeah, that's what I was like. Until then, we gotta use signposts. But you can also, like...
make a manual.
Yeah, so basically, like, look how tall this is. You could just build, like, a temple straight down here. You wouldn't even have to hollow the ground out, and then have it go... I was going to build here a long time ago. Oh, this is where you were going... Yeah, so... I'm just putting a beacon here. Pro said he kind of was going to build something here anyways before I found it. Nope. So go.
I'll fix it.
I still had it up. So yeah, definitely. That would be a great place to put like a huge sunken temple that, and you can even do something like eventually in the temple, it comes out over here and you climb a ladder up the inside of a giant tree from down deep in the ground, and it brings you like up to here, and there's a chest up here, and up here is a chest, and that's where the reward is. Not on the tree, you know, because like I said, people aren't going to be cutting trees down for anything in the game. They don't need to mine or make stuff. Like, pretty much stone equipment will be offered to them at any time. Only stone. Like, you know, if your follower, aka adventurer, is paying good tribute to you and you're happy with them, you know, you can decide to make like a karma level for your own character and have a piece of paper next to it, and you're like, every time you see them do something horrible, you know, you just mark it down so you can actually like build their character. Nice. The city's looking really nice. I just flew in slowly from the jungle and watched it all come up lit up. Very pretty, guys. Thank you.
Welcome.
You know, I'd say we should just save the arena for last project right now, because it's such a big one. Yeah. So, it's going to be so tricky with redstone. Make sure, like, if you're going to build yourself a shrine, go ahead and try to find a location and set it up. Put some signposts. Communicate through signs, people. Don't let people be guessing through ignorance. And
I think this is where Slept is. a beacon out in Ice of Sigma was bailed in.
No, that's Pro, I already said. That's Pro, that's like the exit or something for his. But definitely put a signpost there as well, Pro. And if you guys haven't been up to the Black Tower, a.k.a. the Dungeon Master's home, come up to my place here and scope it out. So yeah, here's the other city too. If you guys haven't seen the second city, you should head over to where I'm at right now. Get to know where it's at. We're going to build the horse track out here, and it's going to go over desert and this plateau. And there's a special witch's hut back here too. So we'll use the glowstone out here for the lights instead of like all the orbs, beacons. I put a little work into this one. It's got like the level 2 enchantment table. It needs an ender. It needs a bank. I think we should do like a lava moat to protect this one with iron fencing. Because it's out in the desert instead, and we use sandstone, it won't burn. Over here is a witch hut, which I already put a loot chest in. You can check out what's in the loot chest. But yeah, the horse track's going to go out here. I'm going to build a beacon onto it right now. I want the horse track to float like over the river into the desert. I think that'll be cool. Hi, Creeper. I like how the mobs just stare at me. They don't do anything. They're like, you are my god.
You're just like, hey, babe, what's up?
Like I said, I use lapis and iron for all of my beacons right now. It's also, it's a death sentence and loss of all items and experience if you destroy even a piece of a beacon. Nothing's very fast to destroy here. So people come up and like, you see them. You see a piece of beacon missing. You should have been following your adventurer, so we'll put that on a signpost right when they spawn in. But everyone, when they first come in, has to sit in front of us and pick their avatar and, you know, give us their character's name.
Destroy is to be smited by the gods.
Exactly. We should all make a weapon called, like, you know, the smite, something smite, or whatever. There's so much. I'm dreaming, like, so far ahead. Crouch down
stick
for Pekazu.
We're going to be
like
people
gods.
With a
nice.
Flaming stick.
Yeah, I made
just make one called the ugly stick.
The stick of death.
You could just make a stick called the ugly stick.
I'll be...
Yeah, see, like in this chest has a wither skull, some food, a bottle of water. Feel free to put like experience splash points.
A certain ugly skin if you beat them with the ugly stick.
Just you also, you know, you got to role play your character. I'm not going to work on this city right now, but, you know, we've got our plans for it. You guys know where it is now. I'm going to head to the Black Tower.
I'm going to come back and pick a bed for a spawn point. I'm right on your tail.
Spriggan Lord Gaia. Lord of the land. I shake of my hand, I swallow it all up and shit out Epis Prime.
Yeah, when I go into when I do.
So remember, us gods, we also only get one animal and one horse. So for now, let's start small, so we don't like.
You know. So we just keep them in our temples or whatever.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, maybe we'll build a mass stable out here at the Black Tower. Up here next to my, you know, floating with like a nice like ramp getting up to it. The horses can climb up a nice obsidian staircase. So yeah, welcome to the Black Tower. Feel free. Mikasa, Tsukasa, of course. Everything you need is here when we turn to survival mode as well. The blue room has the beds. We're not making 20 bedrooms. It's not that geeky. The red room is the trophy room, jam room, potion room, kind of for whatever. Library, anvils, enough full-stocked ovens to bake and cook. Because like I said, once we're in survival mode, after we build this world, we're going to, 90% of the time, we're going to be in survival mode too. So we're going to still need to do some function. You can check the chests are being filled up with like nothing but blocks of iron. This is literally a double chest with nothing but full stacks of blocked iron. Uh-oh. Is it? You think?
I can't.
Yep. I just luckily I saved it. Luckily, I'd saved it. It wouldn't let me get in the chest.
Oh, you open the chest, but now it's glitched.
Yeah, no, it let me open the chest, and that wouldn't do anything. I'm on the froze screen. Yeah, like I said, I'll check and make sure I don't have fingerprints on my disk, because that's always the thing. But what basically, when Microsoft got back to me, they said, currently the PlayStation Network, Xbox Network games run so dependent on the host holding it all that it just occasionally has a cloud hiccup, especially on busy traffic days. I'm checking my disk right now once again. And you know, like I said, folks, when you eject your disk, just for a second, there's always a little bit of pause line to go across your screen. Ejecting your disk each time makes one completely cross. So after four or five ejects, you have like 20 lines going on your disk. No one gets away from that. That's why you gotta always clean your disk every time before you put it in, because you at least ejected it once just before you put it in the box. So that's usually one of the things. Let me clean this up and reboot. I'd apologize, folks, but it's just technology. It's how it works sometimes. It's not really like my choice to have shit crash. It's just the way it goes. Everyone stand up, stretch, take a break. Viewers, participants, stretch your balls out. Jesus Christ. PlayStation. There we go. Jesus. Might be time to like rest my PlayStation for a couple hours here in a bit. Like I said, though, we all flew. Yeah, my PlayStation's kind of warm. Not too hot, but you know, running hard for 9 hours straight right now. But, you know, it was also one of the things we all flew really fast to the house. That's one of those things we've got to be careful of, even in creative mode. Just not turbo running or flying everywhere. Especially flying. The terrain just can't load fast enough. So, please, 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 I'd rather you guys fly across the map at regular speed than have to reload everything. So, it's all good. We went back a few minutes, but you know, nothing had been built, so. Now, we will be playing this, of course, on adventure mode, hard mode, and with drop inventory. We're not making a world for Powder Puff Minecraft adventures.
Station. It's been a good night. Dave catching here?
I don't know. I didn't have any problem with the sticky piston. Just saying. You got to be really careful on like how, what angle you set them down on. That was what I noticed. But other than that, I didn't have any problem. But you know, I guarantee with every update of Minecraft, there's always a few errors that have to be fixed too. You know, we've never had an update that didn't, like, cause some errors. Since patch 112, 113, and 114 have only been trying to fix errors.